Why did I leave the village that night? Because I put my musician's union card in mothballs 5 years ago, when it dawned on me that my talent was an octave lower than my ambition. So while my heart is still on the bandstand, I pay for the groceries away from the piano. And when I get a business call these days, even at 2 a.m, I answer it. This particular call came from a character who handles recording stars. He's known as Senator Bly.
My baby left, and that ain't right. The days are bad, it's worse at night. With no warm arms to hold me tight, the nights are cold, and that ain't right.
All right, let's take it again from the top.
I'm sorry, fellas.
You started out a little flat.
The whole thing's flat.
Let's forget it. Let's do it again, okay?
Senator! Well, Johnny boy, I'll put it here.
Ow!
I'll put it there.
No, I'm better on my feet, especially when I'm talking business.
Oh? Then let's get right with it. I hear you work by the clock.
And I get paid by the hour, too.
Gotcha. Well, here it is, Johnny. That boy of mine hasn't been himself for weeks. Jumpy and the rest of it. Hey, take this here recording session. 2:30 in the morning. You know why? We haven't been able to get a good take since 4 o'clock this afternoon. He chokes up. Sandpaper.
Ah, you don't need me. You need the name of a good throat man.
Now, don't josh me, boy. I'm talking about more than a man's voice. Freddie Tate's in real trouble. He's been put under the boom for something he done 10 years ago. And I don't have to tell you what that boy's done with his life since then.
I know. He's a one-man crusade against juvenile delinquency, so I'll buy his next album.
That's just it, Johnny. There ain't gonna be a next album if he gets written about in this here rag. He'll be ruined. And I'll be minus a client.
Mm. Well, there's nothing I can do. That's the way these magazines operate. They get the facts on a story, they print them. As much as I'd like to, I can't stop them.
That poor kid thinks he can. That's why he's paying him $2,000 a month so they won't print it.
Oh, that's marvelous. That's blackmail.
Templer's plant was in a factory section near the Queensboro Bridge. And from the outside, it looked like the garbage container it was. Most scandal sheets had lost their starch a while back, but Templer was still shoveling up old dirt and getting paid for it. And I wanted it to end. When I got to the offices upstairs, the decor improved. And I don't mean the wallpaper.
Do you have an appointment?
No, but I'm patient.
In that case, I'll put down your name, Mr.
Staccato.
And the name of your firm?
The Fulton Street Birdwatchers, Incorporated.
You're cute. But you're gonna have to do better than that.
All right. I'll try the sincere approach. I'm single, self-employed, would like to see Mr. Templer as soon as possible. Is that better?
So.
I'm crazy about his secretary.
You don't even know my name.
No, I don't. And I'm not going to ask for it unless you get me in there.
Call me Dee Dee.
That's how, Dee Dee.
I'm sorry to interrupt, Mr. Templer, but there's a Mr. Staccato to see you.
How many times have I told you not to interrupt me during my fencing hour?
It's not her fault, Templer. I'm a little hard of hearing.
Well, then you consult an ear specialist, will you? I'm occupied. En garde.
When do you find time for that lovely magazine of yours?
That'll be all, Diddy. Well, Lotsy, I suspect a critic in our midst.
That's not exactly my business, Templer.
Oh, I know your business. We have quite a file on you. Staccato John, but you've never seen fit to work for me. What is it you object to, the prose or the subject matter?
Well, now, Mr. Templer, I just don't know where to begin.
Well, I suggest you find a place to start talking. I have an editorial conference in just 3 minutes.
And who are we crucifying today?
You mean, is it the man you represent? Oh, it couldn't be a woman. You see, they usually make their overtures in person. They have so much more to trade on than just money.
You're a genius, Templer.
But I didn't come here to buy you off.
Oh, now, don't misunderstand me. I never sell out. Why should I? The naked truth has made me a very rich man.
And scared celebrities have made you richer.
You've got just 2 minutes left.
This will only take 10 seconds. Freddie Tate is my client, and I don't want him scared any longer. Now, if you don't leave him alone, I'm going to advise him to release this story to the legitimate press.
Now, why don't you do just that? Now, what are you waiting for?
Nothing, Mr. Templer.
Good. Because Freddie Tate pays me only as long as Freddie Tate fears me. Now, you see to it that nothing changes that fear, you hear? Nothing at all.
I understand.
I expected to come in on a recording session, but one of the technicians told me it was called off. He didn't know where the senator went, but he said Freddie Tate was at the Grand Central Gym trying to unwind. The quickest way to get uptown in the middle of the day is underground. So I decided to invest in the IRT. Jim was on the roof and top floor of Grand Central. And walking through the terminal, it struck me that New York is probably the only place in the world where you can get the wrong train and a rubdown in the same building.
A few minutes?
What for?
Magazine business. I'm staccato.
Yeah. Be talking to steam room, if it's all right with you.
Sure. I've done business in stranger places than that, you know.
No, Freddie, I didn't make a deal with him, and I don't intend to.
Why not? I can't afford what I'm paying him now.
I believe you. Another week of this, and you won't be able to hold down a job as a house singer in a burlesque show.
You just let me worry about that. Just knock him down, offer him a lump sum, anything to get me out of this bind.
You're making my point. It won't get you out of any bind. That's a blackmail business. Every time you honor it, you prolong it. That's why I'm asking you to call Templar's bluff.
Lose everything I've been working for the past 5 years.
Are you worried about your career, Freddie?
Oh, that's the least of it. It's my wife I'm thinking about. My wife and all those people that believe in me. You expect me to expose them to this kind of publicity?
Believe me, Freddie, you won't be risking a thing if you go to the press and you tell them what it is you did.
Could I have some water, please?
Get me some water, too, will you?
Certainly.
I gotta get some more steam if I'm gonna get my voice back.
It's too much for me up here. What I'm getting at is this, Freddie. If you break the story to the press, they'll love you for it.
I'm not so sure.
Still, if it works, Temple will be out of your life. Freddie, I know you're scared. But I can't help you if you're gonna be scared.
Freddie, when you first came into this business, you were nothing, right?
When I left Freddie Tate at the hospital, he was being wheeled into surgery. And from his expression, there was only one song on his mind. A requiem. Greenwich Village is depressing enough at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. What a day. I had tried contacting his wife as soon as it happened, but she was out and I left Waldo's number. That's usually the easiest place to reach me.
No calls? No calls. What will you have?
Why don't you make me an offer?
I'll buy you an order.
I'll buy. With your lousy salary?
Glad to see you.
Likewise.
Look, my cashmere-suited friend, you're richer than I am, but you're not going to live as long.
Waldo, if anyone starts to bug me, just tell them I'm digging the music, all right?
John, we go back a long way together. Why, I broke up your stickball games when I walked my first beat on Mulberry Street. Now, come on, don't hold all of me.
I trip over a body in a steam room. Who do I call? Bill Kovac. He's my favorite cop.
You'll excuse me, fellas.
I know about the boy. I read the hospital report. I want to know what you were doing with this Freddie Tate when it happened.
Playing musical chairs.
I'm serious.
I'm serious, too. If I hadn't swapped seats with that guy, I'd have that knife sticking out of my back.
Well, that's nice. You know who's after you?
Yeah. Could be a guy named Templer. He publishes a scandal sheet.
Templer? Well, that doesn't sound too complicated.
Well, Phil, there's a catch. He just hires people.
Well, so do we. About 20,000 of them. Now, come on, what's this all about?
Wait a minute. Staccato. Yeah?
The call was from someone at the Tate home, telling me that Mrs. Tate was on her way to the hospital. That meant she'd gotten the news. How much of it, I didn't know. But I wanted to cushion the blow before she saw him. I'd never met Freddie's wife, so I stopped the first woman I saw. Mrs. Tate was the second. She'd been told nothing except that Freddie was injured, so I gave it to her the way it happened, including the part about the knife being meant for me. But she didn't want consolation. She wanted her husband. It was even money on Freddie's pulling through. I felt pretty miserable about getting my client stabbed. So while I couldn't help the man at the hospital, I wanted to save his reputation. And the way to do it was by getting hold of Templer's file on Freddie Tate. It was the only piece of evidence that connected Templer with the knifing. But you can't rifle through a man's office in broad daylight. So I killed the rest of the day walking around the city. That's all part of my job. Walking. Walking and waiting.
Hello.
Hello, Mr. Templer. There's a character hanging around here. What do you want me to do with him?
Well, what does he look like? Just see to it that he doesn't get into the plant. I'll be right down.
Hello? Yes? Why, yes, Mr. Tablet. I'm quite sure. Of course, it was difficult to see clearly.
Apparently so, because you got the wrong man. I just got a call from the plant. Someone hanging around on there. Well, who else would it be? Well, never mind the apologies, Lotsy. Just meet me down there right away.
Thank you.
Come on out, Staccato.
Fear is often a delayed reaction. So is guilt. 24 hours later, I was still getting over the fact that I had to kill a man. The kind of man he was makes it no easier. That's why I need Waldo's.
Appreciate a real piano.
Got a report from the hospital on Freddie Tate.
Yeah?
He'd like to know your favorite song. Says he'll include it in his next album.
Oh, gee, that's wonderful. So, what else is new?
Well, what do you want him to do, go with the records? I think it's an honor.
I saw him this morning, you idiot. Wait a minute.
Oh, you bend me.
Every once in a while, I wonder why I went into this business. Then I remind myself. Waldo, he rotates the talent. He hires the greatest musicians in the world. I have low overhead. And I meet the most interesting people in the world right here.